guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to learn, we are going to solve actually some problems based on proton NMR spectroscopy for structural determination, as this technique is most important to find the structure of unknown molecule. So we will solve some problem and find the methods. So first of all, we'll see chemical shift value table. So you have to learn actually this table to solve the problems. So chemical shift value, which will be given to you in the problem for proton NMR, and certain characteristic protons, as you can see here, you have the chemical shift value for that. So cyclopropane, the value is given. If you have any proton which is in the three membered ring, it will give you the chemical shift value, which is in parts per million ppm 0.2 value. For primary protons, the bold one is the value for these chemical shift is for the bold hydrogens here, protons here. So if you have primary alkyl group, the value will come around 0.9, and if you have a vinylic proton, the value will be varying in the range of 4.6 to 5.8 depending on the environment of the molecule. Okay, it's not necessary the values will be the fixed value, these only depend on the structure of the molecule. It will fall in this range plus or minus, that depends on the factors affecting the chemical shift value. For acetylenic proton, you have the value 2 to 3.5. For aromatic protons, you will find the value in the range of 6 to 9. Okay, so especially if you are having any peak in the range of 7, you can definitely say that the aromatic protons are present in your unknown molecule. For fluoride, if your hydrogen, the proton is attached to the fluorine, okay, then the chemical shift value is 4 to 4.5. For chlorides, means if your proton is attached to the chlorine, then it is 3 to 4. For alcohols, CH proton, okay, we have a separate value for alcoholic OH. This is the carbon bearing the proton. The value will vary from 3.4 to 4. You can see it is deshielded. We have two terms here, shielding and deshielding. So we will see what is that deshielding of protons because of the electronegative effect of oxygen, which affects the chemical shift value. Okay, so this again we will discuss during the problem discussion. As electronegativity increases, it increases the chemical shift value of the proton. And why it is so, we will see that. For ethers again, the proton, the value is almost the same as alcohols. So if you are getting this range, it could be your alcoholic or ether carbon bearing proton. Esters, so the proton which is having the nearest group ester, then the value will be 2 to 2.2. Acidic again, we are not talking about the acidic proton here. We are talking about the CH which is having a neighboring COOH group. So the value for this is 2 to 2.5, which is again deshielded. Okay, these values are deshielded as compared to your primary 0.9, right? Higher del value, shift to the higher del value again because of the presence of the COOH group, and this. We will see what is the effect, why it is causing the deshielding here. Aldehydic CH proton, the absorption comes in the range of 9 to 10. So if you are having any peak in the range of 9 to 10, suggest your aldehydic group is present. For a hydroxy OH, the value varies from 1 to 5.5. Such a varied range because the hydroxy group depends on the concentration. If you have a dilute solution or it is a concentrated solution, based on that, the value will vary. For phenolic OH, the value is again 4 to 12. Such a wide range, you can have anywhere between this range. Again, based on the hydrogen bonding, it depends on the concentration, whether you have a dilute solution or you have a concentrated solution. For enolic OH, you can see here enolic OH 15 to 17, highest del value, or you can see highest deshielded one. 15 to 17, if you have any proton, it means you have a neighboring C double bond C, neighbor to the OH. So it is the enolic OH. For carboxylic OH, the proton hydrogen, you have a peak between 10.5 to 12. So if you have a peak in this range 10.5 to 12, you can say your unknown molecule is having acidic proton. right? So you can easily distinguish between aldehydic and carboxylic protons. If it is enolic protons, you can easily find out. You can see some common range here, but you can easily find out the difference between the two. So now we'll see what is shielding and deshielding. So for that, you can see this is the ring current, and in the center you have a nucleus. Like we are talking about proton here. So let's say your proton nucleus is in the center, which is surrounded by the electrons here. And you have put this nucleus in the applied field B0. Okay, so this is the applied magnetic field. And once you put this nucleus in the applied magnetic field, it induces the secondary magnetic current called induced magnetic current. Okay, and this is a flow of the current, magnetic current, which is induced. And in the center, as you can notice, that this induced magnetic current is opposing the applied magnetic field, thus cancelling the net magnetic field effect, and this zone is called the diamagnetic zone. Since the electron effect, net effect is cancelling out, we call it shielding, and therefore the frequency decreases. Okay, so you have to learn this. Then if any proton falls in this diamagnetic zone, and what is that diamagnetic zone? Which is opposing the applied magnetic field. Okay, in the center. So if any proton falls in the center, then the frequency, or you can say the chemical shift value, decreases. Okay, the chemical shift value decreases. But and on the peripheral side, you can see this is it is adding up, right? The induced magnetic current is in parallel with the applied magnetic field. So in the net magnetic field is enhanced here. This zone is called the paramagnetic zone, and therefore we call the deshielding here. Deshielding of protons, and the net frequency is going to increase here. So what you have to keep in your mind, if any proton falls in the paramagnetic zone, then the chemical shift value increases. If any proton falls in the diamagnetic zone, that is in the center, then the frequency or chemical shift decreases. Okay, so the same thing which I have explained is written here. So lower the frequency means we call the upfield shift, or we call it shielded, right? And higher frequency we also called downfield shift or deshielding, means the electronic cloud will be less here, so it will persist at higher frequency. So basically, paramagnetic zone, high chemical shift; diamagnetic zone, less chemical shift. Now we'll apply this concept while solving the problems here. The very first problem, they will give you the molecular formula. C10H14 is given here along with the proton NMR data. The data says chemical shift value 1.39H and the chemical shift value 7.25H. Assign the structure, right? So now, since you have 5H and 7.2 is the value, so 7.2, if you remember, the aromatic proton varies in the range of 6 to 9 chemical shift. And I told you, if you get any peak in the range of 7, that says you have a aromatic group in your unknown molecule. Okay, so, and 5H says it is a monosubstituted aromatic ring. So we found that in this RC10H14, you have an aromatic compound. Okay, aromatic unit is there. So where you have satisfied C6, right? C6 and H5 is done. So what is left then? You have left with C4. H, 5 is gone, okay, C4, H9. Now you have 9H proton, and this 9H proton is splitting same, right? You're giving a same peak. Means all these 9H protons are in the same chemical environment. Or you can also say that these are chemically equivalent. We know that one CH3 is having 3 protons. So it means 3 CH3 will have 9 protons, right? So it is, the probability is that in the center carbon is having the 3 methyl groups attached to it, right? All these methyl groups are in the same chemical environment. So will split and will give you a single peak at 1.39H. Okay, methyl protons we have seen in the chemical shift value range, it is 0.9. But compared to 0.9, it is slightly deshielded or higher frequency, you can see, or higher chemical shift, because of it is attached to the aromatic ring. Okay, so this is the probable structure of this C10H14. You can see this molecule is having now 10 carbon. 6 are in aromatic ring and 4 are here. So it is a tertiary butyl substituted benzene, right? And you can count the number of proton also, 9 plus 5, 14. So you have 5 aromatic proton and 9 primary alkyl group proton. And the deshielding is occurring here, 1.3, because of the these protons falls in the paramagnetic zone of the aromatic ring, or because of the anisotropic effect. You will see that also later on. So this is the structure. Now next molecule, if the molecular formula is given here, C8H9Cl, and the data is given here, proton NMR, you have to assign the structure. So first of all, you have to pick the peak which can easily identify. So in that we have again 5H peak, so which we know that our unknown molecule, this molecule is having aromatic unit. So we have already cleared C6H5 here. So what is left here? C2, 2 carbons are left and 4 protons are left, right? And you have 3 signals here. Only 2 carbons are left with 4 protons. So what is the probability then? There is one more thing, a formula called DBE, double bond equivalence. By using this formula, you can find out that how much unsaturation is present in your unknown molecule. Okay, so this is very important formula. Whenever a molecular formula is given to you, you can directly find out by putting this formula how much unsaturation is present, and then it is very easy for you to draw the structure of the unknown molecule. So learn this formula, where DB is equal to 2C plus 2 plus N minus X minus H divided by 2. Now this molecule doesn't have nitrogen, so we won't put anything for nitrogen. And then rest things you are having here, you can put oxygen. They don't count here in this formula. So if the oxygen is also given here in the molecular formula, you don't have to put anything in this formula. Okay, so 2C. Now carbon is 8 here, so 2 into 8, 16. Plus 2 minus X, X is here 1 halogen, so minus 1, and hydrogens are 9 here, so minus 9 divided by 2. So if you solve this, it is 4. It means your unsaturation in this molecule is 4, where 3 unsaturation goes for the 3 double bond and 1 is goes for the ring. So here ring is also called one equivalent. So 1 equivalent goes for ring and 3 for the 3 pi bond. So total is 1 plus 3 is 4. So we have a total unsaturation present in the molecule is 4, and that we have already satisfied in this aromatic ring. So it means we don't have any more unsaturation present in the molecule. It should be a simple aliphatic structure. So the probability is you have 2 carbon left, so you can write 2 carbons. Of course, 1 carbon is attached with the chlorine, and you are having here signal. One is giving 2H, so CH2. And other is giving 1H and 1H here. So we can also write this carbon is having 2 protons and both are giving a separate signal, HA and HB, right? So one is at a 1.6, other is 1.5. The difference is not much, but it is giving you a separate signal. It means these two are coupling with each other. Okay, these two are coupling with each other here. We will talk about coupling also, what is coupling. Later on, but since the coupling values are not mentioned in this problem, we won't discuss here. So whatever data is given to you, based on that we have to solve it. So these 2 protons gives you 1.8, and 2 protons are coming at this. So what is the probability of the structure? The probability is you have CH2 CH2 Cl, and this CH2 is your signal P and C, giving 2 different signals, means it should be diastereotopic protons. Okay, the proton could be anisotropic, could be homotopic, okay, which are attached to the same carbon, means they are splitting each other. It could be diastereotopic proton, which gives you a separate signal here. So this is a probable structure of this molecule, and do learn this formula You can apply the same formula in this problem also to find the unsaturation. And in every formula, wherever the molecular formula is given, you can find out the DBE to find the unsaturation. Okay, so the next problem, C3H3Cl5, and the data is given two signals. So how many number of signal for this molecular formula? Two signals are given here, and the ratio of the peak area is 1H is to 2H, right? Three are there, and here the splitting also given. One is triplet, other is doublet. Okay, so this is called coupling. We will discuss now what is coupling. Okay, triplet and doublet. So what is the probability of the unit? The probability is, you may have one probability that it could be CH2, right? So CH, this proton will split by its neighbor, right? And neighbor is having how many protons? Two protons are there. So whatever number of protons neighbor has, you add one here and it will split that. So it has two proton, you will add one, 2 plus 1. So 3 means triplet. So this carbon, the proton will split as a triplet here. Now for this carbon proton, it has how many neighbor proton? One proton. So if you add 1 plus 1 is 2, so doublet. So this CH2 will split as a doublet. So we call it n plus 1 rule, which tells us the multiplicity of the signal. So the multiplicity of CH is triplet and the multiplicity of CH2 is a doublet. And that multiplicity always occur because of the neighboring protons. Okay, neighboring protons. So we also called spin-spin coupling. Okay, the coupling between the two spins. So the definition says that splitting of the spectral line occurs because of a coupling interaction between the neighboring protons. So the coupling interaction occurs, and it relates to the number of possible orientation it can adopt, and we apply the n plus 1 rule to count it. Right? I have already explained n is the neighbor. Okay, count the number of neighbors. And neighbor is 2 plus 1, 3, so triplet. For this neighbor is 1, 1 plus 1, 2, so doublet. So this is one probability. So if you have this probability, the other probability is you may have CH, okay? And if the two are symmetrical, okay? Means the two terminal protons are chemically equivalent, means have the same chemical environment. This is another important term, chemically equivalent, magnetically equivalent, or chemically non-equivalent, or magnetically non-equivalent. These terms are very important. So if you have already studied proton NMR, you must be very much clear about these terms. I assume that you have already studied and have a basic knowledge of NMR before solving this problem. Okay, as we are directly solving the problem, so you should have a basic knowledge of it, so that you can understand whatever I am telling here. Okay, so if this terminal two carbons are having chemically equivalent environment, then the two will show the splitting to the center one together. So how many neighbor are there for the center one? 1 and 1, means total 2 are there as a neighbor. 2 plus 1 is 3, so triplet. And for the terminal one, it has only one center, okay, one proton as a neighbor. So it will split as a 1 plus 1, 2 doublet. Okay, so this, but the two are giving the same signal because it should be chemically equivalent. Now we have to draw the structure by using both. So let's say if you have CH2, then apart from that, you have to just put one carbon which is left here, and 5 chlorine are there. So this carbon must be having 3 chlorine. And 1-1 chlorine goes for these two. Okay, so 1-2 satisfy, because carbon is tetravalent. So we have to satisfy this. This is one probability. Now we have to just verify this data here. Now this data says that 1H is 4.52 and the 2H is 6.07. Okay, 6.07 means more deshielding, higher del value. And this chlorine is electronegative, right? So we will see which proton should be more deshielded, means which proton should have higher del value. So if you notice, this particular proton is surrounded by more number of chlorines, right, as compared to this doublet protons. So this triplet proton should be more deshielded in this structure, right, means it should have higher del value. This triplet should have a higher del value. but our data says the doublet is having the higher del value, right? This. So in that case, okay, so in that case, this should be the wrong structure. Okay, it cannot be your correct structure, because here in this, this is having less value of del, because more number of electronegative atoms, higher the electronegativity, higher shift towards a del value. Okay, means you can say more deshielding will be there, more electronegativity, more deshielding will be there, because this will withdraw the electron from here. More deshielding means it will fall in the paramagnetic zone, right? Deshielding means downfield shift or higher del value. Okay, so but here in this case you have only one chlorine, while here you have more electronegative. So this is the wrong structure. So if you see this possibility, then you have to just write down the Cl2, okay, chlorine, 5 chlorine you have to satisfy. And if you see, the terminal CHCl2 are chemically equivalent, both are same. If you just divide it from the center, the molecule is symmetrical. So the terminal CHCl2 are symmetrical, therefore split and give you only single signal. So we have written here B. So if you write down this structure, in this structure also you will get only two signal, one for the center one, other for the terminal one, because the terminal protons are chemically equivalent and will give you a same signal. Now splitting also, as we have already discussed splitting, so splitting we are clear. Now if you see this proton, which is splitting as a doublet here, right, this doublet is attached to the 2-chlorine as compared to the triplet. So 2-chlorine means the doublet should be more electronegative, right? Doublet is having the higher del value, and which is satisfying our data. The doublet is having the higher del value because it is connected to the more electronegative atom, isn't it? So this is the correct structure as it satisfies the data also. Okay, so this is very important. Just simply writing the triplet doublet combination, and if you conclude with this structure, it will lead you with the wrong structure, because we have to verify the chemical shift value as well. For that you have to see all the factors affecting the chemical shift value. So here the factor which is involved is electronegativity. Okay, so this structure satisfies that. Like that you can solve. Next problem, again you can see here only difference is you have only 2 chlorine less here. 2 data is given, 3H and 2H, but both are singlet. It means the 2 signals are not coupling with each other. The 2 protons doesn't have the neighboring proton. So in that you can put the center carbon having the 2 chlorine, because in the molecular formula chlorine is given, 2 chlorine. And one side you have CH3 because 3H is given, and one side you have CH2 because the 2H is given, and you can put rest of the 1Cl left here. Now we need to see whether is it the probable structure. We'll just check it. So this CH3 is giving a singlet. Singlet will be there because it doesn't have any neighboring proton, and the value is 2.2. It is more deshielded because we know CH3 appears at 0.9. in the chemical shift value table, right? But here 2.2, more deshielding because of the presence of neighboring chlorine electronegative atom. Now here this CH2 is directly attached to the chlorine, should be more deshielded, should have more del value, and which is clear, we have 4.02 value for the 2H. Okay, and it is again singlet, it doesn't have neighboring proton here. So this is very much clear. We have, this is should be the probable structure for the given molecular formula and for the given data, as this structure satisfies the data. Okay, so as the electronegativity increases, electron density around the nucleus decreases, therefore the deshielding of the proton occurs and frequency increases, or you can say the chemical shift value increases. The next formula is C10H14. 4 signals you are getting here, you have to assign the structure, right? Now, as I told you, you have to find out the peak, which gives you the clear picture of the unit present in the unknown molecule. So in this data also you can see you have 5H 7.12 means your unknown molecule is having aromatic unit. The second clue is you have 6H proton, and 6H proton means you have two methyl group which are chemically in the same environment, and it is splitting as a doublet here, right? It means this 6H protons is having a neighboring one proton, right? So you can write the 6H which is having a neighboring one proton. So therefore this two, the neighbor is 1, so 1 plus 1 is 2, so the 2 CH3 will split as a doublet. So far we have satisfied that. And again you have 2 proton which is splitting as a doublet, means these 2 proton also have a neighboring 1 proton, right? Then only it will split as a doublet. So we will write CH2 here, and for this CH2 you have neighboring 1 proton, so 1 plus 1, 2, therefore this 2H also is split as a doublet. The data says this only, right? 2H split as a doublet. Now, this center one is having so many neighbors, right? 6 plus 2, 8 plus 1, 9. So, it is going to be splitting as a multiplet, M for multiplet, right? So, multiplicity is clear so far. Now, we have to satisfy the chemical shift value also. So, you write down the chemical shift value 2.45 here, for multiplet 1.86 and 0.88. So this is again clear because this says the probable structure of your unknown molecule is this, where the signal A is for 6H, B is for 1H, C is for 2H and D is for 5H, and this 2.45 deshielding or higher del value occurs for this CH2 because of the ring current present here in the aromatic. Okay, that says these protons falls in the paramagnetic zone. Therefore, the deshielding occur. We also call the anisotropic effect of the aromatic ring. Okay. Because and what is anisotropic effect? That somewhere you have a diamagnetic zone and somewhere it is paramagnetic zone. So, unsymmetrical. Therefore, we call it anisotropic effect. Okay. So, four signal for this. And we have satisfied the chemical shift value. We have satisfied the multiplicity as well. You can also use a DBE formula to find out the unsaturation here. The next problem, C10S13, Cl is given, and this molecular structure shows three signals in NMR. Again, now I hope you can solve and you can pause this video and solve this problem yourself. Okay. As I told you, the number of steps, you can use that. You can use the DBE formula and you can write down the easiest picking units first, and then you can write down the structure. So, first step is aromatic ring, because 5H 7.27. Now, you have 6H here, which is singlet, means this 6H is for 2CH3, which doesn't have any neighboring proton, right? So, the carbon which doesn't have any proton, you have neighboring 6H here. Okay, so this carbon is attached to 2 methyl groups. Again, you have 2H, which is singlet, means doesn't have any proton. So, CH2 doesn't have any proton here. So, we have written this. Now, if you count the number of carbon, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, 10 is satisfied. If you see the proton also, 5 plus 6 plus 2, we have satisfied 13. Cl is left, so terminal CH2 will have a Cl to satisfy the tetravalency of carbon. This is a structure, and this carbon, the quaternary carbon, is attached to the aromatic ring. Okay, so but if you see this structure, then we have to satisfy the chemical shift value also. We are saying that this is a wrong structure, because if you assume this satisfy this, but we haven't seen the chemical shift value yet, right? We have to satisfy that also. We have satisfied the multiplicity, but now focus on the value. So this CH3 shift shows 1.57, while here the two proton shows 3.07 here, right? 3.07. So 3.07, we know that if it is attached to chlorine, electronegative, it should be more deshielded. But here, the 6H protons, 1.57 is more deshielded, right? But if you have this structure, in this structure, it cannot be such deshielded, right? Because it doesn't have an anisotropic effect directly attached to this carbon, right? So this 1.57 chemical shift value we cannot satisfy in this structure. In this structure, it cannot be so much deshielded. So what is the other probability? The other probability is you may have this carbon which is having a Cl, right? You have CH2 proton and you have terminal CH3 hole twice here, right? This is another possibility. Okay, so this CH2 is actually here, which is attached to the aromatic ring, and the CCl here in the center, and terminally you have this one. Now we have to, again, this is multiplicity singlet only. Okay, doesn't have the neighboring proton, so singlet. Now chemical shift value, this is 3.07, which is very much clear because it is attached to the aromatic ring as well as it has the neighboring electronegative atom. So it will split as a show the chemical shift value at 3.07. If you see the CH3 hole twice, this chemical shift value also we can satisfy because it has a neighboring electronegative atom which will withdraw the electron density from here and will show the higher del value. So the probable structure for the given problem is this, where you have signal A, B for CH2 which is attached to aromatic ring, and C for aromatic ring. So this is how you have to satisfy both the splitting as well as the chemical shift value. So if you don't do both, then you will end up with the wrong structure. Okay, so the next problem is C10H12, and here again you have four signal for this molecule. You have to assign the structure. Okay, all the steps you have to follow in the same manner. You can use a DVE formula also. So 5H 7.17 aromatic unit, 3H is always for CH3 singlet, means it doesn't have any neighboring proton, right? So CH3C unit comes for this. Then you have 2H and 2H proton, which is showing multiplet, right? Multiplet, 2H and 2H. And here, if you notice the chemical shift value, it is 0.65 and 0.81, right? Which is very less. It means if you notice the chemical shift value table, we have written that for primary alkyl, it was 0.9. But here it is less than that, and the value for cyclopropane derivative was for 0.2, right? So if you think of that, it could be this probable unit, right? Cyclopropane because 0.2, but it is deshielding because of the presence of the aromatic ring, okay? So if we have this unit, so first of all, the C signal says you have a CH3 which doesn't have neighboring proton, so it is split as a singlet here. So we can write CCH3. Then you have two more carbon left. Okay, so 6 are here, 7, 8, 10 are there. So 2 more carbon left and 4 protons. So 2H, 2H means it is CH2, CH2. And it is showing multiplet. Multiplet means these two are neighbor to each other, which is giving, actually, if you see, you will say that this carbon is having neighboring 2 protons. So it should be 2 plus 1, 3. So it should be split as a triplet, but rather than it is splitting as a multiplet. And why it is so, that we will see, because of the anisotropic effect of the aromatic ring, okay, or anisotropic effect of the ring propane here, right? So any cyclopropane ring hydrogen attached to the benzene, okay, so this benzene is attached here. Nucleus splits into multiplets, and this effect is called the anisotropic effect. Anisotropic effect is uneven effect. Okay, somewhere it is high, somewhere it is more or less. So cyclopropane derivative, where you have one CH3 and aromatic ring, and because of this aromatic effect, anisotropic effect, the two are splitting as a multiplet, and this is a problem. Okay. So the next problem is C9H11BR, and you have four data given here. Okay, so now you can find out the structure of this unknown molecule. We have done almost every kind of problem. 7 problems we have done. I assume that you can solve now this problem. Now here Q for quintet. Quintet means the neighbor is having 4 protons. So 4 plus 1 will split as a quintet. T for triplet and S for singlet. So you can pause the video and just try to find out the structure and you can verify it, because anyway I am going to give you the solution here. So here again you have 5H proton, means aromatic unit is there, and you have 2H and 2H here, right, which is triplet, and triplet means these two are as neighbors. CH2 is splitting as a triplet. And you have a 2H again, which is as a quintet. It means you have this unit, right? CH2. So the center one, for this terminal one, you have 2 proton as a neighbor, 2 plus 1. So it will split as a triplet. For this terminal CH2 also, it is having a 2 proton as a neighbor, 2 plus 1 triplet. So the terminal two are given triplet. The center is having total 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5, right? So quintet. Okay, so quintet, it is having 4 neighboring protons, so it is quintet here. Now Br is left, so the terminal will have a Br, and this CH2 is attached to the aromatic unit. And we need to satisfy the chemical shift value. We have already satisfied the multiplicity or the coupling. Okay, so for quintet you have 2.15. For one triplet is 2.75, and another triplet is more deshielded, having higher del value, 3.38, because it is attached to the electronegative atom, that is Br. Okay, so this value for this triplet goes to 3.38 goes to for the CH2, which is attached to Br. Okay, and this CH2 is again having the more deshielding because it is attached to the aromatic ring. So whatever CH2 group is attached to the aromatic ring, it will give you a peak in the range of 2 to 3. Okay. So that is again because of the anisotropic effect of the ring, or the proton falls in the paramagnetic zone. Therefore, shows a higher del value. So the final probable structure of this given molecule, molecular formula is this one, where you can give the number of signal. The center one is A, which is quintet. And the B is for the triplet, which is having attached to the aromatic ring. You have C signal, which is attached to the, so it's not Cl here, you can rectify this, it is Br, electronegative atom, so signal C. And finally you have D for aromatic ring. This is how you should approach to solve the problem. This problem, again molecular formula is given, and this shows you 2 signals in the proton NMR. The splitting of both is triplet, okay, and one is 3H, should be for CH3, and then you have 2H, you have to assign the structure. You have fluorine also here, and if you have studied proton NMR, we should know that which nucleus are NMR active, right? So proton NMR is, this 1H is NMR active. Similarly, instead of carbon 12, C13 is NMR active, and fluorine also is NMR active nucleus. Okay, so for that we'll make a separate video, and if you have studied then you will understand what I am telling you. As so fluorine is again a NMR. As of now I can tell you proton, carbon and fluorine, these are the active nucleus in NMR, and proton and fluorine has the I value half, so it will show the activity in the same, okay, and will show the coupling also. So now we'll have to find out the structure, because CH3 is splitting as a triplet and CH2 also is splitting as a triplet here. Okay, so this is a probability that you have in the center CF2, okay, and this fluorine will split the neighboring proton here, because fluorine is NMR active. So this fluorine will show the splitting. So for this CH3 you have 2 fluorine, 2 nucleus as a neighbor, so 2 plus 1 3, so triplet. And for this CH2 also it has 2 neighbor, 2 plus 1 3, so triplet. So triplet is only possible this, because if you write CH3 CH2 as a neighbor, then you will get a quartet triplet pattern. Okay, quartet, triplet. If you are having a quartet, triplet pattern, then always CS3, CS2 goes together. But here both are giving triplet, triplet. So fluorine is giving the splitting to 2. Now, satisfy the chemical shift value. 1.75 for CS3, which is more deshielded as compared to 0.9 because of the presence of fluorine. Electronegative atom causes a deshielding of electron and therefore high del value. Similarly, for CS2, which is directly attached to the electronegative atom, will be more deshielded as compared to CS3 and shows a 3.63. So this structure defines the NMR data. And you can make a note that fluorine is NMR active element. So when any molecule bearing the fluorine is placed under the influence of the magnetic field, it produces a magnetic field and split the nearby protons. Okay, so if fluorine is present, then it will split the nearby protons, that you can make a point. And this is going to be the last problem in today's discussion. I hope you have done many more problems and you have done the, you have cleared your concept, right, about the structure determination, and this video is going to be really helpful for you. So 1,3-dibromo, 1,3-dimethyl cyclobutane, they have given you the name. Identify the stereoisomeric on the basis of NMR spectra. So two isomers are possible for this molecule, X and Y. For this, the NMR data is given to you. One isomer gives you 2 signals, the other isomer gives you 3 signals. Okay, and one information is given that doublet have the equal spacing. Okay, so this is based on the coupling. So first of all, we'll draw the structure as it is cyclobutane. So you have to draw the cyclobutane, four carbon member ring. And then 1,3-dibromo. So at 1,3 position, you have to write dibromo. And 1,3-dimethyl, so on the same carbon, you have 2 methyl groups, right? So rest is proton only. One possibility is the 2 methyls are on the same side and Br is on the same side. So if you have this kind of a structure, how many number of signals you will assume in NMR? First of all, we have to find it, right? For that also, we'll discuss one video based on the number of signals. Okay, I'll make a video on number of signals as well. So here, number of signals. These two methyls will give you a same signal because it is in the same chemical environment. We can say the two methyls are chemically equivalent because the two methyls are in the same environment. Both are having proton above the plane, right? And so one signal. If you talk about the two protons here which are above the plane, again it is chemically equivalent because it is in the environment of methyl. So one signal. And the two below the plane protons, which is again in the environment of bromine, so the two will show you the same signal. It is called the chemically equivalent proton. So basically, this isomer will give you the 3 signals. Okay, 3 signals you will get it. Now, other possibility is that the two methyls are trans to each other. Okay, this is again 1,3-dibromo. 1,3-dimethyl, but the two are opposite to each other. Now, if you see, this methyl is in the environment of 2 protons and 1 bromine, and the other methyl is also in the environment of 2 proton and 1 bromine. It means the two methyls are chemically equivalent. So, we'll show you one signal. Now, if you see above the plane, protons are in the environment of methyl and bromine, and below the plane protons are also in the environment of methyl and bromine. It means all the 4 protons are in the same chemical environment, or you can say chemically equivalent. Therefore, will show the same signal. So we have written B here, and this molecular isomer will give you 2 signals. So you can see that 1,3 signal is isomer Y, and this is cis isomer. You can see 2 methyls are on the same side. The other isomer is isomer X, and here the 2 signals, 2 methyls are trans to each other. So this is the trans isomer. So I hope after solving so many problems on structure determination, now you might have confidence of solving this type of problems. And this video, I hope, is going to be very helpful for you, for all the MSc students, for CSIR NET aspirants, the exam is very soon. You are going to appear for that, and GATE examination is also coming soon. So all the best for all the students. Happy learning. See you in the next video.